Right now we are actually in the center of Copenhagen on a place called Søren Kierkegaards Plads, which is the third biggest, empty space in Copenhagen city. The building behind me is called the Domo Visions. Domo Vision is an experiment. We wanted a building, a construction where we could imagine to live like this in the future. We are inspired, all the architects that I work together with, we are inspired by Buckminster Fuller. One of his projects was actually to build a dome above Manhattan. And back in the 60s, he even calculated that the cost of that dome would be paid back in 6 years on the energy saving cost of New York if you did that. And the structure itself is inspired by the geodesic dome. If you look at the beams in the structure, it's actually inspired by the molecule called C60, which is the same you have in the diamond structure. So the structure itself is the strongest structure that nature itself has produced, which is here then scaled up to a building. Then the circular shade is made up of polycarbonate, which is transparent material. So it's kind of both flexible. It is only a climate shell that should protect the indoor climate from rain and from water. It's not the dome itself that's interesting. It is the thinking of, could you live inside a greenhouse? You should imagine that this is a single family house. So the thinking of the dome itself, and that was actually also Buckminster Fuller's idea, is that could you live inside a greenhouse? And from a structural point of view or engineering point of view, you could say that this building that is then supposed to be the house that you live in when it's very cold, when that building is protected from wind and from rain, you can produce a house with a minimum use of resources. You can do it without glue, there's no chemicals in the building. So if you could actually digest wood, you could actually eat your house inside here.
Just because you don't need any protection from rain or from the elements.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
It's important for people to understand why have we chosen this size of the dome and the house. And that was to ask the question, could you live like this in the future? We said it had to be a house that was big enough to host two adults and two kids. So it's a single family thing. And then the architects have calculated, if you chose to live here and you had your own vegetables in the dome area, you would be self-supplied with vegetables for year-round. That's why we have chosen this size of the project. Today we don't have vegetables all over because it's also a cultural house. Vola, who is the dome master here, he just told me that in 2 hours we will have a small concert, so they're busy right now. So if you look around inside here, you can see we are not using it as a home right now. We are using it for office space, actually. So there are 4 to 6 people working here every day.
But this would have been...
Yeah, a bedroom, or it could also be a living room. The house inside the dome itself is in 2 storage, and it's 120 square meters all in all. At least in Denmark, that is supposed to be enough space for 2 adults and 2 kids. This is polycarbonate. We have chosen material that is the same as the plates on the dome itself. The idea is that even in a Danish climate, when you are protected just from wind and from water, you could use a minimum use of isolation material to have a full year living climate here. And then we have outside here, we have a terrace here. And what we have learned is that the architect has chosen it to be on the south side, but when the sun shines, it's actually so hot in here that we would today, if we want to do the project differently, we would have put the terrace here on the north side.
So it gets too hot?
Yeah, in summer. In winter, it's beautiful. Because this is an experiment, you can see there's this white thing.
Yeah.
It's called an IC meter. Uh-huh. We have 12 of these installed. We get a lot of data here, and all data is transmitted to the internet, and even the Danish Technological University have access to the data, and they can do some research, both for their sake, but also for our sake, of course.
Here we have an average temperature in the dome. The temperature right now is 24.7 degrees. Then we have the outdoor temperature. So you can see there's a difference of 6 degrees. Then we have parts per million carbon in the air. It's 550 now. I think that if you're below 800, you talk about in Denmark, then you have a good air quality. And then the last KPI we have is the humidity in the air inside the dome.
Well, today it's chilly out and it's warm in here.
Yeah, exactly.
So
yeah, yeah.
You notice there's a difference.
Yeah, there's a difference. I would say this project, it actually gives full credit in spring and autumn, and then it's raining. Then it's very exciting to be here. If you can see the hat, what we call the hat, uh-huh. is that we can actually lift the roof. So when it gets too hot in here, you open the roof, and that, and then the hot air go out, and the chiller air comes in below in the dome. Right now we're doing a Domovisions 2.0, I call it, in Stockholm, in Sweden. And there we have taken the learning points from Copenhagen to that dome. And there we are actually doing a roof that is twice as big, and we even have not two doors opening, but four doors. So we will have four times as much natural ventilation. But here you can sense the, what I call, this is actually my favorite spot of the dome, because you have the view to the harbor. And you can really feel the size of the dome inside here. It's 10.5 meters to the top. Normally when you're having buildings, you can be inside the building and outside. That means you've been outdoor. But in the Dome of Visions, we're actually working with what I call the third space, because you can be inside the house, outside the house, but inside the dome, and still you're not outside. So we have what we call three spaces in the dome.
And Buckminster Fuller was talking about the greenhouse effect.
Yeah, and you could say that the idea, why does it come up now? In Denmark, we are very much tightening the building regulations in terms of isolation to use as less energy as possible. But we see nowadays that we build walls that are that thick in the housing. And it is both expensive and not very efficient from a space perspective. So what you're playing with here is actually that you're separating the inner wall from the outer wall. So the dome itself is the outer wall of the building, and the inner wall is then the wall itself. Yeah, so you actually turn the thinking upside down. And of course, in Nordic countries where we have not that much light in winter time, people love the sun and love the light. Here we have a Mediterranean climate in Denmark year round. If we move over here, you can see the garden. This is me being in the forest in the center of Copenhagen. And it's actually eucalyptus trees, which normally grows in Australia in very hot temperature and with not that much water.
Yeah. Olive trees. Wow. So obviously it's a Mediterranean climate.
Yeah.
I think what we have also discovered here, if you only look at all the measurements, if you ask the question, would people be happy inside the dome? The answer would be no, because all the measurement shows you that there's too hot in here, or it's too noisy, or whatever. But whenever we ask people, how did you feel being here? They say they have never felt more happy. So how do you measure happiness? Here we have also a technical room where we have a water tank, because we have heated water in the floor to heat it up in wintertime. And then we have the outdoor technical room out there where we are also experimenting with new ways of heating systems. And
geothermal or something?
Yeah, no, it's not geothermal. Actually, you would, if you were supposed to be here forever, you would have constructed the dome on the ground itself. So you would use the heating of the ground from the winter. But since we have to move this, it was too expensive to construct this on the ground, actually, just for a year. And there's actually 5,000 bolt in the structures. You could say that's a challenging thing for us, because when we have to disassemble it and we rearrange it again, That's the, where we use a lot of hours, man hours, to collect it. But the great thing about the structure is that we don't use silicon material. It's all just bolted together, and then the water can run off the structure itself.
So there's no glues, there's no...
Yeah, exactly, glues. There's no glues
yeah,
in it.
Silicone,
yeah,
silicon, exactly.
Yeah, yeah. How the plates have been collected together, yeah. You can see they actually overlap as a kind of, I call it a fish shell. And then it's bolted together. It is a fact that the carbon 60 molecule, C60, is the strongest molecule that the nature itself has produced. You can't get a stronger structure with less use of materials. If you look at the forces from an engineering perspective, if you see how actually light this structure is, and then what happens when you had to have all that forces down to a rectangular construction, then you can see actually how heavy steel you need in order to take all these forces. So whenever human being thinking rectangular, and you can see how heavy forces it has to collect, but when you use the C60 molecule structure, you can do it very light. You can't get a stronger structure with less use of materials. So in that context, I think it's silly not to investigate more. What can we do? Of course, if you did this construction and you have to live there, you wouldn't be probably 100% transparent. Of course, you could use shades and all that kind of stuff. When you look back in time in Buckminster Fuller's era in the 60s, I think that the dome was kind of equal to hippies. And I think when that culture or whatever developed, I think people forgot the dome or even didn't think of that as a new way of living. I think it comes up now because we need to think differently when we talk about construction and urban and city development. I think when you look into Buckminster Fuller and some of his ideas, it's actually interesting not only to look at this size of a dome in a single family house, but could you actually think these waves of construction in bigger urban areas? And if you could imagine that you did a dome above what we call a building block in Denmark, where several families lives, then you actually create a small society in the society. So you maybe could actually even also play with that. And you could start playing with ideas also to maybe let the house go through the dome and then play with that kind of ideas.
So
it's actually only the imagination that sets the limitations.